If you are watching this video, then you've already made your way to the skills practice activities, and I know that I talked about them a little bit in module 2. They're going to become more and more important as we start doing more hands-on Photoshop things. I don't know why that closed, but we'll open it back up. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the importance or why we have these skills practice. So taking a step backwards, in the Photoshop class for a period of time, we required students to read the textbook and answer questions. Those are where your knowledge tests come from. And then we required you to do the activities in the textbook. And then to show us that you were doing those activities, we had you submit what are called skills practice activities. And there might be 5 or 6 per chapter. And it became overwhelming. And what we found were that the students who were doing the reading or watching the lectures and following along and doing all the activities properly, they were getting this unneeded workload where they did all the activities and then they had to submit these other activities to prove that they were doing it. And then we had students that were on the complete opposite side of the spectrum where they just didn't do any of the reading, they didn't do any of the exercises, and they weren't submitting the skills practice anyway. So the only people we were really the only people we were really hindering were the students who were already doing all the reading, and the workload became astronomical. And so in consultation with the other teachers who teach Photoshop, we came up with this happy medium that there are these skills practice activities, and it almost appears that there are activities that you have to submit because they're numbered, and in general things with numbers in my classes, Jessica, have submissions or due dates. And I did that on purpose because I want you to feel like you're supposed to do these, but there's no grade tied to it and you don't have to submit anything if you don't want to. The benefit of these skills practice activities is they're going to include demos of very specific activities that you can follow along to, either recorded by myself or another faculty who's teaching the Photoshop class. We kind of divide and conquer in this class, as you probably realized already. But what's important about it is the textbook covers a lot of things. These skills practice activities are going to highlight what we feel are the most important to learn during specific lessons or specific modules. And so although you're not required to complete these activities, it's in your best interest to do so. And so I'm going to demo the skills practice activities for Chapter 7 or for the lecture on Pixel Basics, because eventually we're going to stop using the textbook because they have not come out with a new version of it. And so I'm going to demonstrate the 6 items that you see on the screen, and then after I'm done I'll obviously put the videos in. And it's my hope that you won't just do it, but you'll want to show off that you did it. Now, some activities are going to be a little bit more straightforward, right? If in the lecture on selections and masking, if we learn how to remove the background in a picture with somebody who has hair, it's called refining selections with hair, you could actually practice along with the activity and then you could submit your file or you can embed it in the discussion. And I would like you to do that. I think that's a good practice. I think if you do it and then you show everyone that you're doing it, it makes you feel accomplished and it also makes sure that you're learning the content. But since it is not a requirement, what I've decided is that I'll give bonus points to people who do these, right? And so a lot of people get nervous when it's time to take the exam at the end of the module. And doing bad in an exam could hurt your score because there's only 5 exams. And so if you bomb 2 of them, it could really hurt your exam score. So what I've decided, and this is the second time I mentioned this in the video, so it's a bonus to people who are listening to the videos, is that if you complete the skills practice activities in these discussions and you post your work, I will give you 1 bonus point towards your exam for every chapter that you actively participate in. And that doesn't mean you have to do all 6 of these and post all 6 of them, but you should be participating in half of them, more than half of them, because if you do these, you're going to end up getting a better score on the exam. The statute of limitations on the extra credit is just until the exam is due. And so if you take the exam early and you don't do so well, you can always come back and do those skills practice and submit your artwork. And you can even ask questions in these discussion threads. It's designed to be a peer back-to-back. Like, you can answer somebody else's question if you know the answer. But you can submit these skills practices anytime throughout the semester. But if you would like the extra credit, you must submit them before the exam due date passes. So if the exam is due on Saturday the 19th, you have until Saturday the 19th to submit these. And then extra credit is not automatically awarded. You must write in the comments on your exam that you would like to apply extra credit towards the exam, and you should say, I did the skills practice for chapter 6, 7, and 8. I think that I did it thoroughly, so I would like 3 bonus points. And 3 bonus points is not 3% on your exam, it's 3 points. And most of the exams are 30 points. And so 3 points is 10% of the score. So you can swing your grade 10% higher if you just participate in these skills practice activities. Okay, that is the end of my ramble. The next video will start the changing image size resolution demo.